Hello, everyone. I'm Joe Baker, co-founder and executive director of Lenape Center. And I'm so happy and proud to welcome you to this exhibition, Lenapehoking, the first ever Lenape curated exhibit in New York City here at Greenpoint, Brooklyn Public Library. In many ways, this exhibit is much more than just the art that you see. It's really symbolic of our return to the homeland. It's about a relationship to the land, to the people, to our histories, which began here at the point of contact. The beginning of the American story starts right here. And what I want you to think about as we move through some of the art today is about the history of the beginning of the American story and what that has meant to displaced people, people who have been dispossessed of their lands, people who have been projected further and further west through forced removals. And throughout all of this time of trauma and chaos, there has been a reverence and a focus on the beauty and the artistry of our culture. And that's what I want to share with you today. So if we go over here, we're so pleased that we were able to feature not only contemporary masterworks, but historical masterworks by Lenape artists of historical beaded bandolier bags. This bag, which is in the collection of the Brooklyn Museum of Art, is a spectacular example of Delaware Lenape beadwork. Abstract floral design motifs, wide straps terminating in three tabs are definitive of this style of Lenape beadwork. We know that the bag itself was probably inspired by the military bandolier that held shell casings. So it speaks to the adaptation of our people being inspired by design and then reinventing that design in a truly original, unique way. But also beyond the beauty, think about this historic period. This is probably around 1850. So given that date, we know that we were the main body of Lenape people located in Kansas on the last Federal Reserve of the Lenape in and around Lawrence, Kansas. So this bag was created during a period of upheaval and chaos because by 1867, we were forced again to be removed to lands in Indian Territory. So throughout this period of constant upheaval in the movement of our people, not by will, not by choice, but by the U.S. government, there was still time for the creation of these spectacular works of art. And I think that speaks to our resistance. It also speaks to our survivance as a culture and as a people. Another historic bag in the collection is this spectacular example, which is most unusual because it features cut beads, which you normally do not find in the old beadwork. These are very small, probably size 14, 15 beads, and they are cut. Beautiful color, a beautiful sense. The colorway of this bag is not only unusual, but spectacular. There's a certain poetry here. Also part of our mission at Lenape Center is education. So another part inclusion in this exhibit is label text, which has been created by Colorado College students during my intro to museum studies class in the fall. Lenape Center invited students, college students, to create label copy for this exhibit. And you're going to find that label copy as observations from outsiders, very poetic and telling of the importance of Lenape art and culture. As a curator, I kind of thought, oh my, I've included my own work in this exhibit. And let me share a little further thought regarding that, because once again, that disrupts sort of the hierarchical formality of museum practice. And I did that because this exhibit really speaks to family and connections, the familial. And that I want to share with you in a more defined way through the discussion of this piece, The Turkey Feather Cape, by tribal member Rebecca Half-Lowry. The turkey feather cape was common among woodlands tribes here in the Northeast. It also could be found in the West. Pueblo people make these incredible turkey feather robes and blankets. But these have not really survived in collections. The first turkey feather cape that I saw was some 20 years ago in a collection. So there are not many of these. So in this work was created anew for this exhibit by Rebecca and her mother-in-law, Sandra Lowry, who is a member of the Yurok Nation. And out of reference to her Yurok culture, the inclusion of the shell and beadwork neck piece, which is a sort of a new contemporary edition that sings of the joining of two families, the Lenape and the Yurok people. Also in the exhibit is the bean tapestries, which is an example of our partnership with Hudson Valley Farm Hub. 3 years ago, we started the process of returning seeds to the homeland, the beans and corn, ancestral beans and corn, to grow here in the homeland, to be returned to our communities once we had a sufficient number of product. And that is in process now. But what I think about when I encounter the bean tapestry and the beadwork is the really magic potential of this tiny seed and the tiny bead, both having the power in combination to create life, to create beauty, and to create sustenance for people. So we hope that those thoughts are with you as you begin to explore and experience the exhibit Lenapehoking. And along with that, in development now is a very rich website that has further information being put together by the Brooklyn Public Library, who's been immense friends, who've become part of the Lenape family, who've invested so much energy and time and work in presenting this exhibit here at Greenpoint. And in conclusion, let me say that I am so thrilled as a museum person to be able to present this exhibit in a public library. And to speak further to that topic, I love the idea, and I think it's fitting, that we upend museum hierarchies and we begin to present art at the very street grassroots level of experience, here in the library, here where people gather to come in out of the cold, to come in and to learn and share and to experience art and culture here at an educational institution that is very democratic, that is open to all people, as the arts should be. It should be experienced by each and every one of us. So we welcome you. We hope you'll come back often to the museum, and we thank you for your interest in our art and culture.